Good afternoon, YouTube. Welcome to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily, and today we're gonna do it again. The video is, ladies, stop hooking up. A Jewish wife's message about sex. It's 2 minutes and 53 seconds long, so this has gotta be some pretty powerful advice if she doesn't have a lot of words for it. So yeah, this is another classically Abby reaction video. You know how, like, when you see, like, a car crash on the side of the road, you can't help but watch? This is my car crash.
Hello, beautiful ladies, and welcome to today's video, where we're going to be talking about why you should stop hooking up.
I have an aunt that she vaguely reminds me of.
If you're a woman in 2020, you've heard you need to be empowered. You do you. The patriarchy is holding you back. Sleep with who you want, when you want.
Sounds pretty good to me, because you own your body. Nobody else. Just like Abby owns her body, and she can choose to sleep whoever she wants. I understand that she is married, so that's her choice to be married. That's awesome, that's great, fantastic. Don't knock until you try it. But I thoroughly enjoy living in sin with my boyfriend, as a lot of people do.
But this is a bunch of lies.
Wow. Don't get angry. Serenity now.
Maybe you want to hook up with a guy because you care about him and you don't want to let him get away. Sleeping with him is the easiest way for him to take you and your feelings for granted. Holding out will tell you whether he's willing to wait and will tell him that you're worth waiting for. I've seen it happen before. Maybe you want to have sex with a guy you really like and can see having a future with. Hooking up with him could mask all of the problems in your relationship that would lead to your eventual breakup and just prolong the inevitable.
Because people only date to get married. There's no other reasons why people date. There's no other reasons why people are social or have social lives. Hey, Ellie, quit licking your toesies on the bed. Not on the bed, you can do that on the floor. Also, I really don't appreciate this really weird heteronormative thing that she's got going. Like, I'm straight, that's and whatever. But like, I mean, obviously she's speaking to a specific audience, but like, also, do you get what I'm trying to say and why I'm frustrated?
Sex will only muddy the waters and prevent you from making a clear-headed decision.
That's not true. That is absolutely not true. This is poor advice. I am 53 seconds in and this is poor advice.
Maybe you want to have sex with someone because you're lonely and it will fill up the time until you meet the right person. Having sex with the wrong person is the easiest way to prolong your loneliness since you'll be too distracted to find Mr. Right. Maybe you want to have sex because, hey, it's fun.
It is. It's very fun. And when you are safe about it, it can be even better. People don't just date so that they can have a family. People don't just date to find a husband. There's a lot of reasons why people are consistently changing boyfriends. You don't have all of the facts as to why human beings date. You're not this tome of knowledge. You don't speak as if you have experience. Sometimes you reference, oh, well, when I dated in the past, yada, yada, yada. But it doesn't feel genuine or real. I feel like she was that type of person who would like show up at a date with a dossier on the guy she was going out with. More tea.
You know what's not fun? STDs, pregnancy scares, waking up next to someone you have no emotional connection with, and wasting your time.
So ladies, make sure that you promised your virginity to your dad. This is so insulting. This is so judgmental. Her whole thing just seems to be judgmental. Like, the next video that pops up for me to watch is why I came out as conservative. And while I do agree that I feel like there are some conservative values that are extreme, I also feel like there are some that aren't as extreme, because I am not left or right personally. But going back to what you just said about STDs and pregnancy scares, yes, those things are a risk when you date a lot or if you have sex with multiple partners. But most people who are intelligent and smart and have a good head on their shoulders, those things probably won't happen to them. Maybe I'm the one who's being a little naive. I don't know. I just don't understand this kind of lecturing. I don't know where she gets off on lecturing people like this. Like, she has absolutely no right. Because you're married, because you're conservative, because you have better values than the average Joe or Jane. You just can preach all of this.
Now let's get the record straight. I'm not saying sex is bad.
That you're saying people who have sex is bad. That's what you're saying.
In fact, sex is wonderful, but sex with the wrong person is not.
That is true, but you don't know if they're gonna be the right person to have sex with until you have sex with them. There is no fucking sex barometer that tells you yay or nay. You don't know it until you're in it.
Sex by itself is nothing. It's regret when the act is done and sadness knowing nothing else will come of it. Love, marriage, a family, a future, all fit in with sex and make sex so much more than a physical act.
That's not always what people want, Abby. Your idea of family and values and marriage and stuff like that does not always fit everyone else's standard or definition. I'm getting so angry.
You know how you crave ice cream, but if you ate ice cream all the time, your healthy lifestyle would go out the window? It's the same with sex. That healthy lifestyle you want disappears when you have sex with anyone and everyone, wherever and whenever. There's a reason that women who wait until marriage to have sex are happier on average than women who do not. A good guy will wait for you, no matter what. A bad guy won't.
Yeah, and if there's a sign on a cage next to a dog that says, "Don't stick your fingers in, dog will bite." It's like,
when you wait, you respect yourself and your body enough to share it with someone on a healthy timeline. You're just waiting to have that ice cream until the moment is right. So listen up, ladies. Let's be classic. Stop hooking up.
I guess she says that so confidently too. Like, women are gonna totally stop hooking up as soon as I say this. It's just women who sleep around. Men are complete saints. You were literally telling women in a previous video that men only have one thing on the mind. And yet you're telling women to stop being sluts. So which is it? You can't have it both ways. You can't have men being these pure, wonderful providers and women being these immoral, slutty beings of sadistic sinfulness. And on the other, then say men are hardwired to only have sex on the brain and women are these innocent, delicate little beings that need to be protected and nurtured. I want Charlize Theron to punch her in the face. But Charlize is better than that, and I know she wouldn't. How many links do you have? Sorry, I don't care. Now we're gonna do my favorite thing, which is scroll through the comment section. First comment, ma'am, if I wish to hook up with someone, it's not for an emotional connection. Here, here, Tori Downs, I am going to just take a screenshot of that. This is the type of woman who would get personally offended if you decided you didn't want to have kids. Marriage isn't everyone's end goal. Disgusting assumptions made in this video. Women only sleep around because they are lonely and wanting to fill a hole in their soul. If you sleep around, you will get an STD for sure. It is every woman's highest possible calling to have a husband and kids. If you sleep with someone you don't marry, you don't respect yourself or your body. Clearly, the ostrich posted, I love how she just assumes all women are straight. You're so blind, Abby. And at the same time, it's not my place to tell you that you're wrong. However, I think that your points are heavily flawed. And I think you need some more real world experience. I don't know if it's because you married so young and didn't date as much. I don't know what it is. I don't know your personal history or your life story. I hope you're a nicer person in real life than you are on the internet, because you come across as a very shrewd, judgmental person with no real argument to back any of it up. And I don't know why you feel the need to continuously push your opinion on how women should live their lives. Men don't always need to be a provider. You can provide for yourself. My boyfriend doesn't provide for me. I work a full-time job to provide for myself and my doggy. We are a partnership in that. Your relationship isn't how everyone else's relationship needs or should be at all. If your relationship works for you, that's fantastic. But I'm going to continuously tell you that I think your views are flawed. And I don't give a shit if you ever see this or not. But anytime you post a video like this, I'm gonna suffer through it. Any of the impressionable young women out there know that there is nothing wrong with A, embracing your sexuality, B, loving yourself, putting yourself first, not having a family, choosing to not have kids. None of those things are bad. None. You should never have to feel shamed for choosing your own happiness over the possible happiness of children that do not even exist, or a husband that might not even be out there. Why don't you just date yourself? It's really nice. It's really nice. As cliche as it sounds, I took 3 years of being in love with me and learning who I was. And that matters too. And if you find you want to have a husband, you want to have a family, that's great. I don't knock stay-at-home moms because I was raised by one. And you know what? My mom would be ashamed of you, Abby. That's saying something. Thank you so much for watching. If you could stand the whole thing, I feel a little nauseous, but that could be the burrito I had earlier. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. Peace and long life. And stay tuned and turn on for more.